Well, I'd like to thank you all for coming here to see me tonight. And, coming here for just faith. Oh, well. No, it's a great cause, and we're so happy. Look at these guys. The place is packed. Fantastic. What a great parish we have. We're going to start with something by Cher.
Thank you for joining us tonight for our second annual talent show. And, you know, Father Pat and his homilies occasionally say, you need to be uncomfortable. Well, just made me really think about my religion and gave me the strength and courage to go out and serve. So we will be starting a new class in the fall. I encourage you to think about joining that. There will be information. We've handed out some information on the seats. And there will be people in the back that you can ask about just faith after the performance. In keeping with community, I do want to mention two more things that are happening this weekend. The Cancer Ministry is sponsoring an anointing mass tomorrow at 8 a.m. And afterwards, there will be a meeting with John Hartland, who will share his experience of talking to the Lord during his bout with cancer. And then the pro-life group is sponsoring a brunch at 10 o'clock. It's a free brunch, so please join them also. Now, it is my great pleasure to introduce our Master of Ceremonies, somebody that's very familiar to all of you, Kathy Jo McNamara.
Wow, what an amazing community. It's an honor to be up here with all that we have. I am checking to see if our first act, you probably recognize her. You see, and here she comes from her favorite point of view here at Blessed Sacrament, our soundboard. Often many of you who attend the 10:30 Mass, when you have that perfect sound going, it is this wonderful young lady who is back there working diligently to make sure that you hear everything in just the right way. She's a member of the drama department at Horizon High School, and she's played the piano for 9 years, and I'd really like to introduce you to a dear parishioner and a wonderful young lady, Kylie Doctor, on the piano.
Thank you.
going to bring out kind of, I'm going to start with a little interesting fact about this family because they are backed by popular demand. It was on January 25th, 1960 that they had their wedding day. And I don't know if this is a coincidence or not, but it was on that same date that there was last Custard's last stand. I don't know about Jack and Barb, but I want Jack started singing at about the age of 50, and Barb started it very young, so she was quite an influence on him. They were members, the prime time singers out of Mesa for over 20 years. They are currently part of Audrey's Angels, and as I said, they are backed by popular demand, Jack and Barb Harrigan. Sunday Mass or during Sunday Donuts. They've been here for quite a long time. In fact, I remember the youngest when she was in her mom's arms and wandering around with us. Gracie is a member of our children's choir, and I present to you two of our favorite young actresses, Grace and Bella Hayward. Hospital in Torrance, California. Well, they ventured their way out to Arizona right here, and their first debut was a year ago in this room on this stage. You may see them at Sunday 5 o'clock Mass, or even some of the children in the audience might recognize them from Mrs. O'Brien's Monday night second grade RE class. Well, tonight, in a little change of pace, I think they meant pace. I think that's what they really meant. Paste, yes, in paste. They will be sharing some important new scientific information using the ancient... I'm losing it today, aren't I? Isocratic, I know, and I said that last night. I'm just setting the stage perfect for them tonight, aren't I? In a kind of a question and answer method, which I ask you to please give Athena O'Brien and her daddy a warm welcome. Let's try it again. Athena.
Okay, you're going to go here. I'm going to go here. You're going here. Okay, here we are. So, well, hey, thanks for coming tonight. And, you know, here's the key to the thing. We just like to thank you 1,000 times. Just, you know, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Let's hear it for the guy who drank before the show. Too much wine. So, okay. So I guess we should start the Socratic here, okay?
Okay.
Start the Socratic question and answer session. Anytime you're ready.
Hey, Daddy.
Yes, what is it?
Why was the dinosaur afraid to go back to the library?
I don't know. Why was the dinosaur afraid to go back to the library?
His books were 6 million years overdue.
6 million? Oh, that's
quite fine. Hey, Daddy.
Yes, honey, buddy.
Why can't two elephants go swimming at the same time?
I don't know. Why can't two elephants go swimming at the same time?
They only have one pair of trunks. Hey, Daddy.
Yes, honey bunny, what is it?
Why do seagulls fly over the sea?
I don't know, why do seagulls fly over the sea?
Because if they flew over the bay, they would be bagels.
We did that one at the Jewish show last week. It was great.
Hey, Daddy.
Yes, honey bunny, what is it?
My dog has no nose.
Wow. Really? Your dog has no nose? Well, wait a minute. How does he smell?
Terrible.
Smell, I get it.
Hey, Daddy.
Yes, anybody. What is it?
What did the judge say when the skunk walked into the courtroom?
What did the judge say when the skunk walked into the courtroom? I don't know.
Odor in the court. Hey, Daddy.
Yes, honey bunny.
What do you call a fake noodle?
A fake noodle? I don't know. What do you call a fake noodle?
An impasta.
It's a fake noodle, an impasta. It's the imposter.
You got it over here.
Hey, Daddy.
Yes, honey bunny. What is it?
What happens if you eat yeast and shoe polish?
Oh boy, this one. If you eat yeast and shoe polish. I don't know. What happens if you eat yeast and shoe polish?
Every morning you'll rise and shine. Hey, Daddy.
Yes, honey bunny, what is it?
Two muffins are in a pan in the oven. One muffin says to the other muffin, "Is it feeling warm in here to you?" And the other muffin says, "Ah! A talking muffin!"
Because the muffin was talking.
Hey, Daddy.
Yeah, what is it?
What did the grape do when it got stepped on?
I don't know. What did the grape do when it got stepped on?
It let out a little whine.
That's true.
Hey, Daddy.
Yes, honey bun.
What did the scarf say to the hat?
Scarf and a hat. What did the scarf say to the hat? I don't know.
you go on ahead. I'll just hang around. Hey, Daddy.
Yeah, that's funny, buddy. What is it?
What did the skeleton say when it walked into a juice bar?
Skeleton. A skeleton.
Yeah?
In a juice bar. So a skeleton walks into a juice bar and says?
I'll have a smoothie and a mop. Hey, Daddy.
Yeah, that's funny, buddy.
Knock, knock.
Oh, no, we're not going to do the knock, knock jokes.
Knock, knock.
No, we're not going to do, because the knock, knock jokes, we're not going to do this.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Lucy.
Lucy who?
Lucy Elastic will make your pants fall down.
What?
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Abe Lincoln.
Abe Lincoln who?
You don't know who Abe Lincoln is?
Let me try one. My dog has no
knock, knock.
Who's there?
Olive.
Olive who?
I love you so much.
Thank you. I think it is. Thank you. Thank you, Athena and her daddy. One more time. Give it up. I hope some of you were taking notes. Those were great jokes to take home to family and friends, especially on Mother's Day. If any of you kids can remember those, so it'd be fun to share with Mom on Sunday. Wow. Well, a little change of pace here. We have one of our longtime parishioners and family friends here. She's an altar server and a member of the Blessed Sacrament EDGE program. So if we have some of our 6th, 7th, and 8th graders here, yes, you guys know about the EDGE program. Yep. And families who don't know about the EDGE program, or if you got some young ones who are going into the grade, it's a great opportunity in sometimes those challenging years of 6th, 7th, and 8th graders to kind of find your way. Well, right here in our EDGE program, they come together and they share their faith. They share the idea of what really is our faith and how we incorporate that in our daily life and challenges that they may see in all of their schools. So I really encourage you to sometimes, as your children get to that age, look toward our EDGE program. It could be a great opportunity. And I think that right here, Juliana Lucas is a prime example of what our EDGE program helps to shape our children and our family. She's been playing the piano for 6 years, and we get to hear her playing. And I introduce to you Juliana Lucas. If you want to approach the, where's my Patricia? Well, Patricia Costello, many of you have heard her amazing voice performing as a cantor during our 8:30 Mass. She has an amazing voice, as I just said, but tonight we get to enjoy her playing on the piano. And tonight, no, you're singing also? Oh, because she's accompanying you. I learn as we go along. So now we get to hear the piano, and might want us with. Should we introduce our companies? I know that she is part of our choir too, and she's very shy about this, but I apologize for not knowing your name. I got Patty. No, I get you. Sharon. And I knew that, and I'm just having one of those moments this evening, but please bear with me. So Sharon is accompanying Miss Patricia, and welcome. Just tonight, but on Sunday during Mass. It's wonderful. Well, I want to just take a quick break and remind all of you, really the reason that we're here tonight is for our emergency fund here at Blessed Sacrament. As Lyle had said, sometimes Catholic charities cannot always help what is the needs here in our community, and people come here to our parish, and it's our neighbors that we really are here not giving a hand out, but a hand up, so that they can sometimes just get back on their feet and feel good and have a little pride. So please remember to take that opportunity tonight as we continue to listen to these wonderful acts and be part of our community of who we are. Pull out that checkbook, which I will also be doing this evening, and drop, a dime, a quarter, a nickel, a dollar, a full check. All of that adds up to help those who are really in need, and reminding ourselves that we're giving a hand up and not a hand out. So I present to you, oh, and somebody was asking about the raffle. We're going to go ahead and sell more raffle tickets because we kind of heard a buzz that people had not had a chance to buy them. In a little bit, closer to the end of the show, we'll be selling more of those. They're 3 for $5. It is a $100 cash prize, so think about that too. So it is kind of an open wallet night. And at this point, which is really great, because we'll hear some good music while you reflect on that opportunity, and I present to you IDK. Thank you.
Okay, I'm short, but not that short. There we go. How are you guys enjoying it so far? Talented bunch of people in this parish. I love the father with three daughters. I love that daddy daughter. That was great. And this is my daughter right here, in case you don't know it. My daughter, Jennifer. We've all been in various bands together. We got this band together just recently. I'd like to do something by Atlantic Star right now.
you, IDK. That's awesome. Another big round of applause for IDK and the new band. That's great. Well, my guess was I put that up a little bit earlier, but you know, how many of you have ever been inside of the front parish office? All right, raise your hand. How many of you probably made a phone call? Oh, I know lots for me. I had to raise my hand 6 or 8 times a day, kind of going, what's going on around here? Well, you know, there's just always that one person who seems to be there. And, you know, I guess I kind of should say, does anybody remember who her name is? Who's that sits in the front? What is it? Let's give her a big hello, and come out, Annie. Well, we know her as our gracious secretary, who probably has the patience of a saint. I think you know how long my patience are, many of you who have seen me around here. But Annie seems to always have that huge smile. And could you imagine walking in her shoes just for one day? All of the phone calls, ring, ring, ring. All of the demands, all of the needs. What's always happening in our parish? Well, there's hundreds of questions. And so today, I give you, from last year, the revenge of Annie. Leave my mic on.
I would like to know what time midnight mass is.
Technically, the mass starts at midnight proper. However, you might be interested in coming at 9 for cookies and milk and pictures with Santa, and then at 10 for decorating the Christmas tree, and then 11 we're going to play musical chairs so that we can get ready for the mad, crazy dash to be in our pews by 12 o'clock.
What is your name?
Marianne Canning. Thank you for calling the Community of Blessed Sacrament.
What day of the week will Ash Wednesday be on this year?
Really? Here's a hint. Starts with W.
Wednesday?
Bingo. Thank you for calling the Community of Blessed Sacrament.
Do you have ashes to go? And if you do, what time?
Yes. As a matter of fact, we do. Due to the 2 people who call every year and ask the same question, but the drive-through window at Blessed Sacrament and St. Bernadette's closes in 20 minutes, so you better get there fast. And if you leave right now for that drive-through window for your ashes to go, you can also go to the second window for confession. And not only that, if you get out of here right now, you might make it to get that ticket so you can be first in line next year.
I don't appreciate your flippant answer. With whom am I speaking?
Marianne Bateman. For calling the Community of Blessed Sacrament. How may I help you?
Can anyone have their feet washed at the Holy Thursday Mass?
Yes, everyone is welcome to have their feet washed.
Well, you know, that could take a long time.
Oh, did you not get the memo?
What memo?
Come with clean feet.
What is your first and last name?
Marianne Miller. Thank you for asking. Father Pat, don't know about Father. I don't know if I want to answer this. Thank you for calling the Community of Blessed Sacrament. Oh, I can barely hear you when you whisper. Oh my gosh. I'm sorry. Yes. Yes, I know. She's so hard to live with. I don't know what to do. But Father can only cast out demons, not mothers-in-laws.
What can I do?
Go to confession. Thank you for calling the Community of Blessed Sacrament.
Hello, may I speak to Marianne? I'm calling about the new job position. My name is Grace.
There is no one by the name of Marianne that works here.
Amazing.
Well, I have a question. Excuse me.
Yes, please.
How many people here in this audience, just raise your hands, knows what day my birthday is? Well, that's not a very lot of people, and you call yourselves good Christians.
Now, would anybody like to apply for that job? Not I. Annie, thank you, and I think from on behalf of the entire parish here, we thank you, Annie, for being at that front desk and keeping us happy. Well said, well said. Remember again tonight what we're here for, the reason we are. I hope that you were thinking about those things during our great last two performances. We are here to help those in need. Now this group, I probably should remove that. No, you want the chair, don't you? There's not much to say about this group because I think many of us have them as friends in our circle, but you cannot miss them coming out of church and what they're doing every Sunday morning to really help our parish, help those in need, but in part of the proceeds of what they're sharing with us today really helps our Renew, Repair, Refresh. So with further ado, there's really not much more that I can say about a great, wonderful support group for our parish who's been part of this parish from the get-go, the Women's Club.
tomatoes, 9 Arco gas cards, 8 Home Depot, 7 Barnes & Noble, 6 Smart & Final,
5 Perkins Cups,
4 McDonald's, 3 Bath & Body, 2 Costco cards, Sunday morning, we will sell to you 11 Walmart Sam's Club, 10 Sweet Tomatoes, 9 Arco gas cards, 8 Home Depot, 7 Barnes & Noble, 6 Smart & Final,
5 Perkins Cups,
4 McDonald's, 3 Bath & Body, 2 Costco cards, and a gift card from Target. Every Sunday morning, we will sell to you 12 CVS, 10 11 Walmart Sam's Club, 10 Sweet Tomatoes, 9 Arco gas cards, 8 Home Depot, 7 Barnes & Noble, 6 Smart & Final,
5 Perkins Cups,
4 McDonald's, 3 Bath & Body, 2 Costco cards, and a gift card.
Pick up your CVS gift card and these other fine gift cards after all the masses. Many more are in the office. Thank you.
Thank you. Wow. Does that get the message across? How could we ever, any of us, now forget our Sunday morning gift card purchases? Thank you, Women's Club, and thank you for your continued support for all of these years and all that you do for us. There's another big thank you that we would like to also do. I think many of you have had dinner tonight, and we have an amazing set of gentlemen who have supported this parish in all kinds of ways. So tonight, if you're in the audience, the Knights of Columbus, please stand, and we want to give you a big, huge thank you. You're always in... Well, and I think probably a few of them had called tonight. I'm hoping you're not standing in the kitchen, but hopefully if you are, you can hear me. They're always in the background in a lot of those meals that we get, the fish fries that we have, events. A lot of us ask them to do the cooking, and there they are in the back cooking. So thank you to the Knights of Columbus. Really appreciate that.
One of her favorite tunes is a special one that we get to hear yearly. Is there any birthdays in the audience?
Yeah.
We have a birthday? Well, Miss Ridius, come on down. No, are you joshing me? Well, okay, we're going to do two, because we're going to embarrass someone who we understand has a birthday in a couple of days, who is very pivotal to our community here, who does hours and hours and years, a part of us. And I understand her birthday is in 2 days. And this, we'll have, Catherine, we're going to have you stand. Our birthday song tonight is dedicated, and she's going to shoot me, and since I'm not here, she really can only just shoot me from afar. She is. To our Marianne Canning, this is dedicated to you. Those bad days from a wonderful, amazing woman. Here we go.
difficult to inhale and then go out and then inhale two or three times at one
time. I'm only 50 and I couldn't do that, so I'm loving that. Yay! Another big round of applause. Happy birthday, Mary Ann. Thank you for all that you do for us in our community. And all of you, keep that sunshine in your heart. Our next performer is a young man who, if many of you have seen the Christmas pageants for many a year, I think he kind of started the beginning of his career here at the Christmas pageant. As I understand, we had a music director prior to Mike who saw this talent, but then we had a Pat Hersey who was part of the group in getting that Christmas pageant together, and she really encouraged him to reach out and sing. And so the next performance is being part of the community and being recognized, and I know he's grown and mature, but tonight I present to you a grown-up, Christian Reeser.
Oh,
raffle tickets. And who do I have back there? John?
Yep.
All right. Mr. Escajeda? Let's have you bring that up, and we'll pull out your raffle tickets. And, oh, can we do a couple lights? I can't see them. Oh! And we'll put up just one, maybe one side, and see if it'll glow over. Little Miss Escajeda, would you like to do our raffle drawing? Come on up. We have a father-daughter. And again, as I was thinking, in the women's group and the Knights of Columbus, we have many, many ministries who just do amazing things to keep our parish going and so vibrant. And I know Father Pat and I had oftentimes really talked about how vibrant this group is. So on behalf of all staff and Father Pat, thank you to every one of our ministries. There he is. And I can let him say something, but we might go on a long time for the homily. So if you don't mind, Father, I'm just going to say thank you on behalf of the entire community, all of our ministries, Just Faith. Really take a moment and really prayerfully consider being part of Just Faith. I will be the first to admit I've not done it myself yet, but as soon as I find the time, I will be there. And I really encourage you guys to take that time. I've heard nothing but rave reviews. So, Ms. Fajeda, for our $100 winner, here we go. All right. Oh, you're over here. Right.
Eight, six, two, one, seven, oh.
Let's read that again. Oh, and who is it? All right, come on up. Nice and focus. You get to present to her her $100 gift in cash. Double check that. All right, now are you a prisoner here? A visitor? Welcome. Ellie. Thank you, Ellie. Here is your gift. We thank you for participating in the raffle. We also remind you, okay, we're good, perfect, that we are well moved to our next. We can go, oh, there we go. All right, all good? All right, thank you. Thank you everyone who participated in the raffle. What a wonderful night. So our next act, thank you. This is a younger sister of, older. Oh, I always do that to you. Watch these girls grow up. They have a beautiful family. Earlier we heard her sister. But Marie Eve has been playing the piano for over 9 years, and she has moved and is part of our Life Teen program. She came through also part of our EDGE, our Life Teen program, which is for our high schoolers. And oftentimes we as parents struggle with keeping our high schoolers involved in our faith, and you sometimes wonder. But this group is amazing. Sunday Mass, they join. It just sends chills. I've had my children go through this program. I've watched them grow. It brings tears to my eyes. They're in college now. But this program really was pivotal in helping them to understand that there are other teenagers who feel strong about their faith, our commitment, and the social action of the things that we need to do to keep us strong and to keep our teenagers focused on what life is really all about and keeping their faith, our faith, in their heart. And I hope and I know we will see this come through in her piano playing, but now I present to you Marie Eve.
Thank you.
Okay. Well, we're going to do a little quick change of pace. Many of us know of the Carrick family and Julie, who has been quite the singer with us, and we know her as a professional musician. But tonight, she doesn't have Kurt with her. But she does have, well, I don't want to call him a runt, but this one was a runt. This young lady was a runt. But you would never guess that as you see her. So we're going to bring her out, and I'm going to introduce you. Well, we're going to kind of be quiet. Is that all right? Yeah, let's stay kind of quiet. She's going to take her a moment. This is our runt friend, Bailey. Hi, Bailey.
Would you like a treat? Would you like to do some nice things for the... Give me that.
Oh.
Give me that out of your mouth. You're not going to eat off that.
Do we just expect dog tricks?
Should
like
do,
basic dog
should
tricks
we do
from
some
a
dog tricks?
Let's start with dog tricks because, well, you also like know that as it moves along, will a Carrick ever be without music?
Oh, we all have music.
We all
have
the
music.
Entire family,
the
I'm
entire
sure.
Family.
Dog included. So I give this date.
Would you like
quietly.
To do your warm-ups? Come on, do your warm-ups. That's not a warm-up. Bailey, we're inside. Inside voice. Bailey, inside voice. Inside? No. Where's your inside voice? Bailey. Inside? No. Inside voice. Good girl. Thank you. Now, would you like to earn a couple more treats? Can you sit all the way down? Stay there. This is very important that we wait till I count to three. She can count. One, two, three. Three. Okay. Very good. Would you like to do another language? Sit down. Sit down. Espérate a tres. Tres. Uno, dos, tres. Oh, that's her first language. Okay, Bailey, here we go. A couple more tricks. Can you be very gentle and shake my hand? Oh, that's not too gentle. Sit down. Shake my hand. All right, we're going to go right to the big trick. Ready? Hold on a second. High five. All right. Okay, can you sit down? Would you like to sing? Would you like to sing? What is this? Where's Kurt? Come here. No. Bailey, come here. Maybe Heidi could come here for just a moment. Bailey. I shouldn't have said her other friend's name because she's looking for him and he's in Williams. Okay, sit down. Singing? That's not really singing. That's more barking. So maybe if we all help her sing. Can you go like this? Well, you know what her favorite trick is? Her favorite trick is to get 300 people to howl. Okay, one last trick, Bailey. What are we going to do? Sit down. Sit down. Can we try to just do a nice, gentle voice? Shh. No. Inside. No, we're inside. Inside. Inside voice. Shh. Shh. No. Inside. Shh. No. Bailey. Kitchen, are we? No. Inside voice. No treats until we do inside voice. No. Bailey, are you sad? Inside. Down, down. You knew where that treat was, didn't you? Sit down. All the way down. Now.
Inside voice. Good girl. Thank you.
Say thank you to everybody. I don't know if we're going to try singing one more time. How about your warm-ups? Just do your warm-ups. Just your warm-ups. Warm-ups. Can you sing for us? Well, you're going to have to go to Bailey the dog. Come here, Bail. Come on. You're going to have to go to Bailey the dog on YouTube to see her singing in the kitchen. Apparently, she is a singing in the kitchen dog instead of on stage. So she won't be able to tour with the Carricks. Say bye, Bailey. Say bye.
Are we on? We'll never see the Carrick family again. And one, we've always sung Kurt and Julie, and now we get to see Bailey. So thank you, Bailey. That was beautiful. And check out the YouTube. That's
so
wonderful.
So now I want to just take a minute to remind you, and I know that you're always wondering. I'm up here always asking for money, and many of you have seen me do that for quite a few years.
But I wanted to let you all know, not that I want to make a big deal, but I would never stand up here and ask you to give one to our campaigns or two what we're here tonight, but I did sit in the back and I wrote my check, and I'm going to walk back as we introduce to you, and I'm going to drop my check in the blue, and I hope many of you will follow me. I now introduce to you again for IDK.
Wasn't that fun with Bailey? He was a lot better than you think, because he didn't do what some other animals do when they come up on stage, famously. He was a good boy. All right, we're going to do something from, what is this guy's 70s? Grand Funk? Yeah, I think it's 70s. Something from Grand Funk Railroad to end our set. Some great stuff coming up right after us. Ready?
To your town, we'll help you party down.
you very much. Thank you. Introducing the next act. You've seen him around, heard him playing a lot. See him directing the choir on Sundays. He does a great job. And I'll tell you what, he looks really good in black. Ladies and gentlemen, Mike Barta.
Joe, it's been a long time since I was around. It's kind of good to be back.
Johnny Cash! Woo! I love those men in black. You know, I'm going to take a couple of minutes here. And, you know, I know it's in your program, but there's a lot of people we really need to thank for having this night for us. Most of all, to the parish staff, Father Pat. Thank you for making our community as vibrant as it is, as loving, caring, and inviting for everyone who wants to be part of it. But again, that Just Faith community, this just gives you a taste of what they can do, the power behind their faith that really makes them bring this out. So again, I ask you to really prayerfully concern. And those who, I think we've got a few in the crowd who have gone through Just Faith, would you be embarrassed if I asked you to stand so that people have questions, or if you are available for talking to them and you would like to raise your hand and let others know, I think with great pride, please stand if you are part of it, been through Just Faith. This will give you kind of a recognition of a face, if you guys look around. If you do have questions about Just Faith, those are your friends, they're the comrades who will take you through that process, and I really encourage you and bless you all for doing that, so blessings there. With this event, amazing. The director, Mike Barta, thank you. Part of that committee, Lyle Skritzmeyer. Yeah, let's give, you know, we'll take a few minutes here. They have worked tremendously hard to make this
finance person, but really one of the strong believers in all that we do here, Lyle Skritzmeyer. It's part of our also our board. The decorations. You all know that we have a preschool kindergarten here, directed by Heather Freyer. The decorations that were out on your dinner table tonight, those were made by the children in our school. They just sent me a message a few minutes ago that said that what they would like to do is donate those to the cause here. So if you would like to take one of those centerpieces home, if you would drop any donation in the blue box, our blue light box, you may take one of those home with you. So we're not putting a price tag on it. That is something that's up to you. But if you leave a donation, feel free to take one of those home with you and enjoy them for time to come. Promotions, Sharon Manis and Claire Windenhall. Thank you very much. You had amazing entertainment before. Again, Mike Barta for your musical and sharing your musical talents with us all the time here at Blessed Sacrament. Lights, Jim Finks, part of IDK. Thank you, Jim. Eric Anderson and our Miss Kylie. Really appreciate that. Programs, again, Mike Barta, and many of you may have remembered she's been here for many years and she left and she's back. We're really happy to have in our liturgy department, Julie McBride. Thank you, Julie. Our photographer, I'm sure he's here, but I haven't seen him yet, Richard Hart. He takes many of the pictures throughout all that we do here at Blessed Sacrament, so Richard Hart. And the man on video, which I'm afraid to see at the end of the night, but he and his family, his three beautiful children, I know we have a new baby girl back there that I've not seen in a while, the man's family, Ryan. Thank you. And you know, one person who really does keep this whole thing going, where do I have Lyle? Is he around? One person, which we saw, we hear Annie's Revenge. Can I see Annie up here for a minute, please? Where is she? Oh, are you taking the mic from me? Do. Okay.
Come on, Ann.
Where is she?
And Mike.
Mike.
And Kathy Jo. Now, normally, and I know Mike is going to be disappointed, at this point we give flowers and that. And I know Mike's going to be brokenhearted. We're not going to do that. But yesterday we had the opportunity to see the Women's Club. And so, in appreciation for all the work these three have done, we have gift cards for them and that. So thank you, guys.
It's a pleasure. Oh, it's a pleasure. I love this community. As I said to Father, I call myself an OP. It warms my heart. I call myself an OP, an opinionated parishioner. How many of us are that? No, don't raise your hand. I'm just kidding. I promise I told him I would keep it really quiet. Well, to end this show, and I think I hope that a few of you will take time and read the very last thing that says, special thanks, of course, to our Knights of Columbus for providing our dinner, the hospitality committee who does their potlucks, and always is gracious in serving all that we do, and all the performers. We will have one more performance, but let's give a big round of applause for all of our performers tonight. What an amazing show you have presented. Had the opportunity, and as I spread this, if you guys would like to come out as I read this, I think it's kind of neat we just take a minute and read here that's at the end of our program. And whether you're singing songs of praise, enduring phrases, making others laugh, or trying to survive as office staff, remember to let shine the light of the divine, spread Christ's love, as Catholic social teachings say to us, become a member of Blessed Sacrament's Just Faith and really share that. So we thank you all, and I present to you Mike Barta and his beautiful 8:30 choir, and thank you all of you for being with us every Sunday at 8:30. And here's just a taste of what you can get at 8:30 Mass. Someone in that back corner, grab a light. There we go. All right. All right.
It's a prayer.
For singing with us, our choirs, our group, the entire Just Faith group. Lyle, I am saying we're Just Faith. Remember, this talent show is provided to you. They do have baskets as you're leaving the door. If you drop the donation in there and you decide you want to take, each of the doors have double baskets. If you want to take, drop a donation and grab a flower on your way out. If there's anything that we can do, please don't hesitate to call Annie in the office. Ask about Just Faith. You saw those who stood and are part of Just Faith in the past, and our pastor, Father Pat, Marianne Canning, Marianne Bateman, Julie McBride, all of your staff. You guys have a blessed weekend, and happy Mother's Day to all who are mothers or to be mothers, grandmothers, great-grandmothers. Happy Mother's Day. God bless, and have a great night.